am so happy. I can't wait. And I've always been a part of the family, and I've always been glad that you guys have accepted me as a part of the family. And I can't wait to see him down the aisle.
I'm very excited. Can't put it in the words right now. It's one of those things, it's just a feeling. I know this is the right thing to do, and I'm just ready to get it over with.
Love and marriage go together like a horse and carriage. This I tell you, brother, you can't have one without the other. Love and marriage
Hi, my name is Catherine Hepburn Boisicote, and I'm 23 years old, and I am a newlywed.
Hi, my name is Carl Boisicote. I'm 23, and I'm a newlywed.
Carl and I met back in 2009.
Towards the end of our semester.
Back at NCC. And he was walking down the hallway, and he caught my attention. I should say his sneakers did. He had on a pair of Griffies, which I love because I used to be a sneakerhead in high school. So I walked down the hall, and my friend actually knew him, Jalissa. So she introduced the two of us, and Carl would like to say that he's bagged me, but yeah, it didn't work out that way. I actually got Carl's number, and we started off from there, so yeah.
In the beginning, it was funny. We started off as friends. She would come over all the time. I would spend a lot of time at her place. A lot of Street Fighter was being played in my room. Not what everybody thinks, but that's what was going down. We were the best of friends, as you could say.
A lot of people believed, oh, you know, your life's going to be over, that's it, you're done, you're not going to be able to have fun. But I think it's a perfect time to get married when you're young, especially if you find the right person. And if that person is your best friend, you have everything to live for, though. I think it's really good to get married young because you get to experience everything together and learn everything together. So it's pretty cool.
You're never promised tomorrow, so I wanted to take advantage of every minute I have with this girl. There's a few memorable moments from our wedding day. One that sticks out to me, I don't know why, is my younger cousin Herbert being there. I don't know why that sticks out to me, but I just remember opening the door to the cocktail hour and... stuck out to me, but other moments that I really will cherish are my first dance with her, my first dance with my mother. There was just a lot of love in that room, and I can't pick one.
When Carl sang to me, that was the most special moment ever. Frank Sinatra, L-O-V-E. That was special to me because he's always nervous to sing in front of anyone. He sings to me in a house or in the shower. But that was really special that he had enough courage to do it in front of everybody. So I felt really good about that. Planning for a wedding is no joke. There's a lot involved, and it was a struggle when it came to the financial status and everything else that came along with that. It wasn't a joke. So just glad we made it.
We're excited. I can't stop smiling. My cheeks hurt.
You go home and you're going home to see your husband. Like, that's the face you want to wake up to. That's the face you want to go to sleep to. So it feels good. Like, and we respect each other more. We're more calm and patient with each other. So it's a good feeling.
It's different being on your own. It's liberating.
Welcome to my humble abode. Commode. Whatever.
I enjoy it. The privacy, your own space.
Hi. I'm actually getting ready for work, so.
She just took a nervous juju.
Shut up.
But there's things I miss at home. Right now we're, you know, sleeping on the floor.
I got my twin bed set up. You know, me and Kat keep a happy home. You gotta keep separate beds. Somebody told me that. I ain't gonna tell you who.
We make do with the things that we have, but I enjoy it for the most part.
We're so used to having our parents around, and of course I had a lot of responsibilities before I moved out, but it's just really different now, especially like we don't have any furniture yet. So we're like, you know, we're sleeping on the floor and we're trying to get our furniture together, but you know, it takes time, and I know it'll definitely work out right, but I definitely miss home cooked meals. Like, I work all the time, and Carl works all the time, but it's all good. We still go home for that good old home cooked meal.
It's a bit of an inconvenience, being that a lot of my stuff is still back at home, and we're in that transitional period where I'm here, I'm there, I'm still between a rock and a hard place, I guess you could say.
I miss being around my mom, fussing with her sometimes, and just having her there to just talk to at any given moment.
There's a lot of things I miss about being home. The cooking, for one. And just being around my brothers, sisters, you know, that type of thing.
How's it feel to have two moms now?
Pretty good. I mean, you have one or the other to run to talk to, so it's good to have a mom prep talk. So, it feels pretty good. I love both my moms.
As long as we have you guys around, we'll be perfectly fine.
Well, the advice that I definitely want to give to those out there who's considering marriage is go for it. You're never too young, as long as you know in your heart that it's the right person, and if that person is your best friend, then go for it. You'll have no regrets.
Don't do it.
Bye.
Try to separate them. It's an illusion. Try, and you will only come to this conclusion. Love and marriage, love and